children, today I am going to present the third chapter in this question. The chapter name is Globes and Maps.
The next chapter is about globes and maps. In this chapter, we are going to discuss about the meaning of globes and maps and the comparison between globes and maps. The main topics are elements of maps and types of maps. The first topic is about globes. Globes are spherical models of the Earth. They can be rotated on their own axis to help us see the different continents and oceans of the Earth. In this picture, we can see the globe. The axis of rotation can be seen in this picture. So the globe rotated on its axis, which help us to see the different continents and oceans of the Earth. So what are globes? Globes are spherical models of the Earth. They are the representation of the Earth. The next topic is about maps. Maps are representations of the Earth or parts of it on flat surfaces. They are easy to carry around. People use maps to locate places or to study parts of the Earth in detail. So children, why the people use maps? The people use maps to locate places or to study parts of the Earth in detail. So what are maps? Maps are representations of the Earth or parts of it on flat surfaces. You can see the picture of map here. In this map, we can see the different countries on a flat surface at a time. So maps are representations of the Earth or parts of it on flat surfaces. The next topic is about comparison of globes and maps. The first difference is, a globe is spherical in shape and is a true model of the Earth. But a map is a representation of the Earth on a flat surface. The next difference is, a globe shows us the features of the Earth as they really are. The globe shows the real features of the Earth. But a map often changes the shape of the features and land masses. There may be changes in the features of the Earth in map. The next difference is, on a globe, we can see only a part of the Earth at a time. But on a world map, we can see the entire surface of the Earth at a glance. Because map is a representation of the Earth on a flat surface. So we can see all the countries of the Earth at a time. The next difference is, a globe is difficult to carry around. It is very big, so it is difficult to carry around. But a map is easy to carry around. We can roll it and carry around. The last difference is, a globe cannot show the features of the Earth in great detail. But a map can show any number of details depending on its scale. So it shows the clear picture of the Earth in detail. Next topic is about types of maps. The first one is political maps. It shows the location and boundaries of different countries. So political maps is used to show the location and boundaries of different countries. This is an example of political map of Europe. So in this map we can see the different countries in Europe. The next map is physical map. It shows the landforms or physical features of an area such as mountain, rivers, seas, plains and deserts. This is a physical map of Africa. In this map, we can see many deserts, plateau and other landforms on the Earth. The next type of map is road map. It shows the roads of a country or of a particular area in detail. This is a road map of India. This map shows the details of different highways and other routes in different states in our country. The next important type of map is city map. It shows the roads, streets, railways, hotels, hospitals and other important landmarks in a city. This is a city map of Delhi. In this map, we can see many landmarks like Red Fort, Parliament House, Supreme Court, Lotus Temple, etc. So, the city map shows the details of the landmarks in a city. The next type of map is thematic map. It focuses on certain features or characteristics of an area. Example, the climate or the crops of a particular area. This is a thematic map of India. It is a map showing natural vegetation. Children, what do you mean by vegetation? It is a type of plant which is found in a particular area. So, the map shows the different types of plants grown in a particular areas of India. So, the different types of maps are political maps, physical maps, road maps, city maps and thematic maps. The next topic is about elements of a map. First one is title. It will tell us which area is covered by the map and what type of map it is. Area covered means is it a climate region or a desert region, is it a vegetation, etc. What type of map means that different types of maps are there. Physical map, political map, city map, road map, etc. The next element of a map is orientation. It tells us where the four cardinal directions are on the map. The four cardinal directions are north, south, east and west. Most maps are drawn with north at the top. The next important element of a map is symbols, keys or legend. A symbol is a picture or sign used in a map to represent something from the real world. Some types of maps use colors as symbols. That means blue color for ocean, red color for bridge, etc. The key or legend explain what each symbol stand for. So what do you mean by key? The key explain what each symbol represent. If it is blue, it is represent ocean. So if it is black, it is represent road. That means what? The legend or key. Next element of map is scale. You know that it is impossible to show real world features or distances on a map the way they truly are. So the maps are always made to a specific scale. Scale is the relationship between distance on a map and the actual distance on the ground. So what do you mean by scale? In map, scale is a relationship between distance on a map and the actual distance on the ground. It is explained through an example. If a map has a scale of 1:100, it means 1 cm on the map equals 100 cm or 1 meter on the ground. If a map has a scale of 1:1,00,000, it means 1 cm on the map equals 1,00,000 cm or 1 kilometer on the ground. So there is a relationship between the distance on the map and actual distance of the ground. The important point related to scale is graphic or linear scale. That means many maps show the scale as a line with the distances marked on it. And this is called graphic or linear scale. This is an example of linear scale. You can see the picture here. The distance between two places on a map can be measured with the help of a divider. The divider can be placed along the linear scale to find out the actual distance on the ground. So it helps to find out the actual distance on the ground. Learn what do you mean by linear scale or graphic scale? The scale as a line with distances marked on it is known as graphic or linear scale. So children, this is a map showing the elements of maps. So in this map, we can see first one title. It is in the bottom of the map. That is world climate region is given there. It is the title of the map. Then second one orientation. It is on the top. That is north. It is the orientation. North side is given. The next one is about the symbols. That is, here some colors are used as symbols. And key. Key means what? It indicates each color. You can see that box there. That is known as key. The last one is about scale. That is, linear scale is given because the scale which shows the distance. We can see the distance here, 6212 kilometer. So that is a linear scale. Children, hope you understood the important elements of maps from this picture. So we finished the third chapter in social, globes and maps.
So what are the important points we covered in this chapter? Globes, maps, and the comparison between globes and maps, types of maps and elements of the map. So we finished the third chapter in social. Thank you.